Welcome back to At Your Leisure. I'm Scott Huntsman. This is our What's New segment for this week. I'm back with Project Ruby Red. Today we're going to be installing a set of TerraFlex's Falcon Shocks. The Falcon Shock line is manufactured here at TerraFlex in their facility in West Jordan, Utah. So let's go on inside and let's see what that's all about and where they make these shocks. Okay, we're inside TerraFlex office here. We're in the showroom. This place is a candy store to me. I'm digging it. I'm here with Dennis Wood. You've seen him on several YouTube videos with TerraFlex. Dennis, tell us a little bit about the company.
We've been doing the Jeep thing forever, and the major, you know, the suspension obviously needs to work well. We work with some great shock manufacturers, but what we found is we needed a shock that would do some specific things for us to increase the ride and the handling and so forth on our Jeeps. A lot of these companies are so big, it's the old trying to turn a battleship thing. They just weren't able to make those changes. So we said, all right, we're gonna do it ourselves.
So you guys are indeed, you researched, you developed, and you came up with your own.
We had some really good engineers, some really sharp guys, and they put together the Falcon Shock with some unique designs. I mean, they're Jeep specific.
Wow, they manufacture those here in West Jordan, is that right?
Yeah, yep, a whole, walk you through back there. We do the whole thing here.
Well, let's go take a look.
Let's do it.
Great. So Dennis, this is the most impressive part to me about this. We start with raw material like this. This is the end product. Really, how long does it take them to produce something like this using these machines?
You know, they've got it down to it's going to take 3.5 minutes to mill that end cap. And then it's going to take us another 2 minutes to do this shaft. So they have it all lined out so that we know how long it takes to produce all the parts to make a shock.
This is really, really cool. This is the fascinating part about all of this to me. Dennis, this is a fascinating looking machine right here. What is this thing doing?
It's a shock dyno. So when these shocks come out, they hang them on a rack and they sit there for 24 hours. No shock will be sold before it's time. Once it's been tested and there's no leaks on it, we bring them over and they'll do like 20% of the shocks. And if the parameters aren't within what the computer's looking for, they pull them out, tear it apart, find out what's going on, check a few more in that batch to make sure they're not bad. We're looking for quality. We got to get them out there, get it done once, get it done right.
So Dennis, here's our final product. We're all the way to the very end. The fit, the finish looks good, and it's been tested. Where does it go from here?
Well, we got to get it in a box. I mean, it's all stickered up, looks good. So these guys box them up, and then it goes to the end of the building, and they ship them out from there. But you know what's cool? When they put them in the boxes, the guy that built the shock actually signs the card that says, I built this. It's called pride in your work.
Wow, I can't wait to look for it in the shocks that I have, because the thing that comes next for me, getting a set of these bad boys on Project Ruby Red. So let's head on over to our shop now and we'll get them on and try them out.
Cool.
Thank you very much. Okay, we're back at the shop. I've got my Falcon Shocks. Three of them already installed. I'm down to the last one. So this is really an easy installation with these. They've got great hardware that lets you mount them just so. Now, up here, slotted and a single bolt. So getting it in and started and then onto the bottom is really a simple step, and I'll show you how. Okay, as you can see, we've got the shock in place. Two bolts on top, the one stud at the bottom. It was really simple to get that in. The skid plate clears. One thing I wanted to mention, I also replaced with TerraFlex new springs from their CT3 suspension. The springs are paired with the shocks for their best performance. Let's get the wheel on, and I want to get this down and try it out on the road. All right, we've got the Jeep out. We've been driving it. I'm really happy with the performance of these shocks. At least on the road, we're going to try them off-road. These Falcon Shocks look fantastic. They're not only a quality product, but they've got a great aesthetic. They've got great instructions. great illustrations to go along with it, so the installation was really very simple, and I'm very happy with the result. I'm Scott Huntsman. More at your leisure in a moment.